Hello and welcome to Teach, Read, Play. In today's video, I'd like to welcome you into my classroom and tell you a little bit about the experiences and the learning that's been taking place in year four this academic term. I hope that you enjoy this video. If you do, remember to comment, like, and subscribe to see more content like this. Welcome to my Year 4 classroom. Inside you will find an array of the pupils' work and my live modelling. Each morning I create my own key vocabulary word map for the children to use on the whiteboard. This is to help enable their vocabulary across the curriculum. Teaching across the curriculum is one of the things that I enjoy the most at our school. Each session is carefully thought out, following our curriculum guide and careful sequencing. Today, I'd like to show you a little bit about what we do for each subject area. To begin, I would like to show you some of the English modelling and content that we have created in Year 4. To give you some context to this, I would like you to know that in Year 4, we have been recently reading Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. We've spent 4 weeks reading this text together, and during that time we have conducted some read and comprehension sessions, and we've also done lots of variety of writing outcomes. We have written for a range of genres whilst reading Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Those include newspaper articles, family trees, character analysis, and themes and conventions. One thing that I'm extremely passionate about is reading into writing. So we have been reading Charlie and the Chocolate Factory during our reading sessions, and we've then been writing about it in our writing sessions. So let me take you on a journey through my modelling throughout reading Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. To begin our understanding of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, we made some predictions based on the text. After reading the text, we decided to create our own family tree and to look at the details of each character and given them a little bit of context. During our next English lesson, we spoke a little bit about what each character was like, and we began to write our character analysis on each character. As I modelled, I liked to use a range of colours to help the children magpie ideas. As part of our GPS learning, which is grammar, punctuation and spelling, I taught a lesson based on relative clauses. Here I used the writing stimuli of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory to help build sentences with relative clauses. I've also shown the difference between the relative clause and the main clause using coloured pens. Here we worked on creating some direct and indirect speech. This is an example of our planning for our newspaper article in English learning. This is my modelling for our newspaper article reporting on the golden ticket vines. I have used a range of colours to demonstrate the use of relative clauses, orientation, and text features. This half term, I've really enjoyed teaching maths. We have covered three concepts: number and place value, addition and subtraction, multiplication and division. To teach maths, we use the Singapore approach to mathematics. We also follow the Maths No Problem guide and curriculum to help sequence throughout the school. Here you can see some of the examples of my modelling using the concrete, pictorial and abstract method. I will talk you through some of the strategies that have been used. In addition to some of the workbooks, we also place journaling into our sessions. We have given the children opportunities to create their own journals to show their mathematical understanding. Here is an example of a child's modelling demonstrating their understanding of their times table knowledge. Here is an example of a child's modelling who is modelling their understanding of the 9 times table. These are some examples of my modelling in maths where I have modelled the concrete, pictorial and abstract methods of each strategy. I usually pre-model or write up my date and learning goal before the session to save myself a few precious minutes during that lesson. Here are some examples of the children's work on their whiteboards once I've set them off on an activity. They are demonstrating their understanding and their knowledge. We use a range of concrete resources to help the children aid their mathematical understanding.
As part of our science learning, we have covered 2 topics so far. Firstly, our topic was based on hearing. We then moved on to electricity. Recently, the children have been learning about electrical circuits, series circuits, parallel circuits, and here I'm going to show you an example of some of the modelling that I created with the children in my class. I then will show you some examples of their work. I hope you enjoy it.
We created our own science experiment, testing the pitch and the volume of water. Here is how we wrote up our ideas.
The children loved learning about how we hear sounds and how the different aspects of the ear works. I've highlighted the scientific vocabulary that I would like the children to use in this piece of modelling.
We then created some work on electrical circuits, carrying out investigations and building our own circuits using the equipment that was available. PSHE has also been covered as well during this term. This is something that I'm extremely passionate about, and during the recent events I felt that it was very prominent in our classroom. Therefore, we have covered aspects about ourselves and our feelings, as well as mindfulness and meditation. I have spent many lessons with my children guiding them through what mindfulness is, how to take part in mindful activities, and also bringing their awareness back. I've used a range of activities with the children, based from reading to breath work and also body scans, to help the children conduct some mindful activities. Here we created a lesson full of mindful activities to help the children with their mindfulness skills. The children absolutely enjoyed this learning, and it was really fundamental to help support their well-being and mental health. Here's a guide through my modelling and my planning, as well as the children's work. Here are some examples of me teaching the children about mindfulness. They've also been conducting some work on climate change during our geography learning this half term. This is one of the things that children have absolutely loved learning about. From greenhouse gases to the ozone layer, pollution, and what climate change is. The children have worked extremely hard across the unit, creating their own presentations and posters and information leaflets, as well as essays to help them with their geography learning. Here's a guide through to my modelling and some of the work that the children have produced.
Here we pose critical questions and big questions that we would like to think about during this half term. The children then created their own essay based on climate change. Please check out my climate change video to find out more about this.
I hope that you've enjoyed watching my guide through my classroom and my modelling, as well as the children's learning journey. If you'd like to see more of this, please comment, like and subscribe. Tell me what you enjoyed about this video, and also give me some feedback on what you'd like to see next, so I can start working on the next video for the next half term of learning. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.